The seven fundamentals of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Among the fundamentals, principles of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah is that they love and show allegiance to the family of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, acting upon the commandment of the Messenger of Allah when he said about them, أذكركم الله في أهل بيتي, I remind you of Allah concerning my family. Look, subhanAllah. And I remember one of two brothers that they were Shia and they became Sunni, alhamdulillah. And he said, my family, they keep saying that you Sunnis hate Ahl Bayt. I said, Akhi, this is the book by Sheikh Fawzan. He's one of the Saudi scholars, which people lie about. And they lie and guess. Take to her the book and tell your mom, oh my mom, oh my dear mom, read it. This is from our usul to love them. But the Shia, what they say, no, if you love them, you have to hate Sahaba. Just as the Christians. They said, if you love Jesus, you have to hate Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. No. Both of them came with the same aqidah and the same manhaj. Likewise, the Isa alayhi salatu wasalam wa nabiyyina alayhi salatu wasalam. Naam. So, this from the aqidah of Ahlul Sunnah Jama'ah. And wallahi, this is logical, rational argument and refutation and guess. Those wallahi and guess Ahlul Sunnah. Wallahi, read the books of Ahlul Sunnah Jama'ah. Kutub al-Sitta, naam. And the other books of Ahlul Sunnah Jama'ah, the Masanid, na'am, and the other books of Ahlul Sunnah Jama'ah, they have abwab chapters just dealing with what? With fada'ilu Ahlul Bayt, the virtues of Ahlul Bayt. Please, if imagine I hate someone, do you think I'm going to travel around to collect his virtues? How? And you know, subhanAllah, the most narrator among the Sahaba that narrated about the virtues of Ahlul Bayt, Aisha. How can you lie and guess Ummuna Aisha and Arda? She said she used to hate Ali and so on, based upon fabricated stories and mis-explained stories, or ahadith. So now, so why we do that? Because we are following the commandment of the Messenger of Allah, وسلم, the hadith in Sahih Muslim. When Prophet said, I left two heavy things behind. So one of them is the Quran. He said, follow it. Then he said, أُذَكِّرُكُمُ اللَّهِ. He never said, follow the Quran. He said, He never said, follow Ahl Bayt. He said, follow the Quran. But he said, أُذَكِّرُكُمُ اللَّهِ فِي أَهْلِ بَيْتِ. I remind you. Naam. As he said, I remind you of Allah concerning my family. From his family are his wives, alayhi salatu wasalam. As we have mentioned previously in al-video mustaqil, na'am, a separate video that we spoke, that the wives are Ahl Bayt, with the clear-cut verses and ahadith. Na'am. So Sheikh Fawzan said, they are from Ahl Bayt, the mothers of the believers. For indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that they are from his family. After addressing them with his saying, Ya Nisa al-Nabi, O wives of the Prophet. He also directed pieces of advice to them and promised them a great reward. إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمْ الرُّجْزَ أَهْلِ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. Allah, the meaning of the verse. Allah wishes only to remove a rujz, evil deeds and sins and so on, from you, O members of the family of the Prophet, and to purify you with through purification. So the wives are Ahl Bayt. Naam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Surah Hud, when the malaika addressed the wife of Ibrahim, قالوا أتعجبين من أمر الله رحمة الله وبركاته عليكم إيش أهل البيت. They said, are you amazed with Allah's commandment? Naam. Because when the angel gave her the glad tidings of, she will have a baby, a child. So they said to her, are you amazed with Allah's commandments? Indeed, Allah's mercy and the blessings be upon you, O Ahl Bayt. And the malaika were addressing who? The wife. Naam, so the wife are Ahl Bayt. Likewise, this verse is what Ahzab. Al-ayat al-sabiqa wa al-lahiqa, clearly Allah addressing the wives. That's why one of the Shia scholars, when he noticed that you cannot really refute this verse, is clearly speaking about the wives, where he said clearly, he's ma'ruf, his name Ali al-Qurani, he's clearly exposing the belief of the Shia. Said this verse is being changed. That's not the place of the verse. But when he was asked, okay, where is the place for it? He didn't know how to answer. SubhanAllah. Now, so these to love Ahl al-Bayt, from them the wives. Likewise, the Sheikh said, the five Prophet are those who are the close relatives of the Prophet. And the intent here is specifically those who are righteous from amongst them. Now, as for his unrighteous relatives, such as his uncle Abu Lahab and those similar to him, then they have no right. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, تَبَّتْ يَدَى أَبِي لَهَبٍ وَتَبَّى. Na'am, perish the two hands of Abu Lahab and perish he. Na'am, so when Prophet ﷺ said to take care of his family and to respect them and they have a right over us, the believers, na'am. Na'am, likewise we mentioned Ali ibn Abi Talib, Fatima, na'am, Al-Talib, Al-Aqil, Al-Abbas, na'am. These are from the family of Al-Hashim. They are from the family of the Messenger of Allah, alayhi salatu wasalam. So then Sheikh said, so a mere ascription, na'am, or relationship to the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wasalam, without an individual being righteous upon the religion of Islam, will not benefit that person anything with Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Na'am, so look, subhanallah. Na'am, doesn't mean because you are a family prophet, Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wasalam, therefore you are promised paradise. Na'am doesn't mean that. So what we have to understand, that the in order for you to be to have a right over the believers, as mentioned the hadith, then you have to be from the righteous ones, from the righteous ones. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, ya ma'shara quraish ishtaru anfusakum la ughni ankum min Allah shay'a ya Abbas. Amr Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam la ughni anka min Allah shay'a. Then he mentioned all his family. So the meaning of the hadith was said, oh assembly of Quraysh, save yourselves from the hellfire. I will not benefit you in anything with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Abbas, uncle of the Messenger of Allah, I will not benefit you anything with Allah. Oh Safiya, auntie of the Messenger of Allah, I will not benefit you anything with Allah. Oh Fatima, daughter of Muhammad, Ask for any of my wealth and you desire, but I cannot benefit you with Allah. So clearly, that look, and it's a clear invitation against those who say Prophet Muhammad is a false prophet. Why, look what he said to his own family. I cannot save you, meaning that you have to, of course, if you follow his teaching, you'll be saved. But meaning doesn't mean because you are his daughter or you are his family, therefore you'll be saved automatically. No, you have to do righteous actions. نعم إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات. Except those who believed and do righteous deeds, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. So this is the aqidah of Ahlul Sunnah al-Jama'ah concerning the family of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So then the Shaykh said, alongside this, it is impermissible for us to exaggerate concerning them, like seeking to draw closer to them with any form of worship, or that we believe that they have the ability to harm or benefit besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to his Prophet alayhi salam, قُلْ إِنِّي لَا أَمْلِكُ لَكُمْ ضَرًّا وَلَا رَشَدًا. Say to them, O Muhammad, it is not in my power to cause you harm or to bring you to the right path. Meaning that, he's not open. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has no control over people's hearts to turn people's hearts toward guidance. Rather, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is upon him to show people the guidance and to call them to it, however it's upon him to follow it or not. As for the control of everything is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned another verse, قُلْ لَا أَمْلِكُ لِنَفْسِي نَفْعًا وَلَا ضَرًّا إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ وَلَوْ كُنْتُ أَعْلَمُ الْغَيْبَ لَاسْتَكْثَرْتُ مِنَ الْخَيْرِ وَمَا مَسَّنِي السُّءِ. Say, O Muhammad, I possess no power of benefit or hurt to myself except as Allah wills. If I had the knowledge of the ghaib and seen, I should have secured for myself a lot of wealth, and no evil should have touched me. Surah Al-A'raf. So all these verses clearly mention that refutation against those who call upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Na'am, min bab al-awla, some people call Prophet Muhammad's family sallam, to remove hardship from them or to provide for them, dead ones. Na'am, like Shia, they call upon Ali or they call upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No, we don't call upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Na'am, we don't call upon Ali. We call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is our messenger. Na'am, he's the one who showed us the correct way. We love Ali ibn Abi Talib. We love Ahlul Bayt. But we do not raise them with the level of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, we love Jesus alayhi salam, but we don't raise him with the level of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So people, what they do, they lie against Ahlul Sunnah. Just as the Christians lie against the Muslim, they say because we do not believe Jesus is God, therefore we hate Jesus. Shia, what they say? Because we do not raise the family of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the level of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, therefore what? We hate Ahlul Bayt. No. We love them, but we love them in accordance to the Sharia which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down to his Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Naam, so the Shaykh said, if this was the condition of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salam, then what about other than him? This clearly shows that the belief of some of the people about those who are attributed to the family of the Messenger are sorry. Naam. So he says here, this clearly shows that the belief of some of the people about those who are attributed to the family of the Messenger is a false belief. Naam. So this is a seventh fundamental of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And inshallah ta'ala, we carry on the rest of the principle next time. Wallahu ta'ala a'azzu wa'alam. Subhanakallah bihamdik. Shadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wa sallallahu ala imamina wa nabiyina Muhammad. Wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa sallam tisliman kathira.